Is surfacing to become Illinois' next Senate president.
And she's no stranger to Springfield. WGN political reporter Tamon Bradley spoke with her today. Tamon.
Micah, Joe, it didn't take long for a leading candidate to emerge in the race to take Illinois' Senate's top job.
The support is really pouring in.
Senator Kimberly Lightford is the apparent frontrunner to become the next Illinois Senate president. A Springfield legislator for more than 20 years, Lightford is majority leader, the number two Democrat in the chamber. Lightford said she was stunned when President John Cullerton announced his retirement last week.
It was kind of like this shocker when John Cullerton just dropped the mic on us and said, hey, I'm done. It was kind of like, okay, where do we begin?
The caucus begins with a contest to replace Cullerton. Lightford has the early advantage thanks to support from influential senators, among them Heather Staines, Andy Menar, and Tony Munoz.
So I was approached by Senator Staines and to say, hey, Kimberly, if you don't run, I will. It's time for a woman, you know. And Senator Menar's like, hey, if you don't run, I will. You know, it's time for the downstate voice.
If Lightford wins, she would be the first black woman to lead the Senate. She wants to take on Springfield's culture of harassment and intimidation.
There's a lot of dictatorship in Springfield, and it's a changing and moving environment. The culture is a lot different today than it was as it relates to men and women relationships, and it's time for us to have those uncomfortable conversations around relations.
A cloud of political corruption scandals has descended on Springfield, but Lightford is not ready to commit to specific reforms.
So I'm not quick to jump on any one's recommendations. I think we need to engage and get our members involved. That's one of the reasons why my leadership would be different.
And then there's the issue of America's longest serving speaker of a state legislature, Michael Madigan.
You know, I've got a good relationship with the speaker. I actually respect him as a legislator. He's done an amazing job over, 40 years or more. You can't take it away from him. He's a political genius.
And you're comfortable with someone having that kind of power for that long?
Well, I mean, the power is in the imagination. It's what you give them. I'll have power, too, as a Senate president, so we can balance our power out.
It looks like Lightford's main opponent for president is Senator Don Harmon. His schedule was jam-packed today, and we hope to talk to him soon.
Well, it seems like everyone is deferring at this point to Senator Lightford, right?
It does seem that way. She has been having lunch with some of the people rumored to be in the mix, bringing them into her tent. Munoz was someone who we thought might be able to get enough votes to do this, but now he's backing her. She clearly knows what she's doing behind the scenes in terms of just getting everybody on board and showing perhaps like the power of inevitability.
All right. We'll see where it goes. Thanks, Tamon.
Thank you.